Welcome to What's on the Table, the weekly nerd podcast, or almost weekly nerd podcast, about all things nerd, so nothing is off the table. We podcast every week, so almost every week, from a Visionaries comic book store and cafe, in Bonnie Drugs, so come on down. And, so what's on the table today, guys?
Music.
Yes. And we got like just a bit of every kind of music on the table, as it sounds. So, who wants to start off?
Yes, I'll start off.
You seem to have a week.
I take the initiative.
Roll initiative!
Oh, I actually got some bag of dice. Want me to?
No, why not? Pull out a 1d4 and we'll see. We'll see who goes first.
Okay.
I think that's how we should do it from now on.
Roll initiative. Okay.
That one?
Yes, I won't be talking first after all.
Oh, I got a 2.
Yep. Yeah, you're going first there.
It's not.
It's a 5, but it's still better than a 2.
That would have been more funny. That's not proper wording.
I don't want it. It would have been more funny.
You start rolling.
But
oh, I'm sorry. I completely missed that. I am one of your hosts, Radioactive Hatter, or Wasteland Hatter, or Toxic Hatter, depends on how you know me. And to my left is
the one who rolled a natural fail, Cosmic Vagabond.
And
we're going here, Shin.
Who still rolled like crap, but beat us all.
I wanted a 3 so I could make a joke, but apparently life's like, no joke for you. It was a Kabuto joke. No. Do we know if those are
it? No, it was Monty Python syndrome.
Yes, it was! 1, 2, 5, 3, sir, 3!
I forgot my holy hand grenade of Antioch yesterday.
I can get one. They actually sold them on Amazon.
Oh, you know Amazon shouldn't sell weapons of horribly holy destruction.
Holy destruction.
But music. I basically like mostly metal and some dubstep, but I kind of just go in the general direction of whatever sounds good to me. So I do have like one band I've grown to be like a favorite. Disturbed and Breaking Benjamin. Then again,
Disturbed is a good one, and Breaking Benjamin, I've heard a few of their songs.
I have like most of their CDs that they have. They're coming out with a new one since they got back together. I haven't heard anything from it yet, but that's kind of, I like the whole, like, I'll first get a CD and I'll know a few songs I've heard on the radio, and then I just go through the rest of them. At first it's like, it's okay or so, then keep going through it, and then you start like, I actually like this. You start feeling it. And it's fun to listen to something you've never heard before.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Give me a chance. Don't be so close-minded, America. There are people out there that are really awesome. You have to give them a chance.
I understand that very well, because at least I have a whole list of people here I listen to that I went through. I sort of, like, no, write this down. And then I just kept writing and writing and writing, and it wouldn't stop. But I know of at least one person on this list that isn't from America, or is at least from America, Canada, and that is, I just lost his name, Jamie, I'm going to butcher this last name, but Gutierrez, so he makes basically kind of, he's odd. It's kind of like pop, rock, it basically whatever suits his fancy at the time. And
he takes a dart, and it has a whole dartboard full of all the different genres. Like, what do I feel like doing today? Throw. Oh, rap.
He has a giant ball with all of them, he just spins it. Thwack. He's done one on, like, he's done a song. I don't think there was any lyrics to it, or if there was kind of like chorus-y, like, you know, the Skyrim kind of stuff, but it was about, because he always does these really cool music videos with them, and it was about a video game character that every time she died, she got respawned in the same spot, but she learned from her mistakes. And it was like, she walks in, kills a dude, and then immediately gets caught by a trap and dies, so she responds first, oh, I know where that trap is. And she keeps going through it over and over again, does all these cool things, and eventually just ends up with her victorious. I'm like, that's awesome. I want to see that. I want to see that as a movie. Well, technically, I guess we already have that as a movie. Which I didn't see. I need to see that movie. Day After Tomorrow?
Next?
No. It's based off an anime. We talked about this, I think, in the episodes. Well, the fight humans are fighting aliens and then, exos.
Yeah, with Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise, that's it, yes.
So that was based off of an anime?
Yeah, that was based off an anime. The anime was a lot more. Like, they showed every single one of his deaths, and he got a lot more. Yes, a lot more like that. But yeah, that was based off an anime. And he based. The guy who wrote the anime based that off of. Dying and responding to video games. That idea, so. It was funny too, though. Jamie, he's really cool. He talks with his audience. He has a running gag, and in all his videos, he puts a duck. Like a little toy duck. And you have to find out where the duck is. And if you can comment where the duck is, you win a prize. And that prize is basically just a shout out. But you get them. And there's one where he asks his audience for artwork in the video. And I actually submitted some, and it's in there for like 2 seconds. And then my dude immediately gets killed by like, I think a truck. Like, there's a whole, like, it's all about like indie song, like people, how industry will take people from online and make them into big AAA songs, like Justin Bieber. And there was one where they literally put him in the video, and they put him into a press and became like a smoking hot babe, and she made like this pop song that everyone loved. But then it was about like, she loved, the indie folks need some love too, and there's a whole band with a bunch of indie people, and then a truck with the advertisement for that woman showed up, slammed into all of them and replaced it. And it was, I'm like, oh. Well, I was in there for 2 seconds, that's cool. And he did one about how he doesn't care if people steal his song, because if they do, it's more free advertisement for him. And things like that. So it's basically whatever he wants to at the time, and he's really good. I'll try and put clips of his songs into the podcast.
Kind of reminds me of Andrew W.K. what he says when, you know, people listen to his music, he encourages to listen to it any way possible, whether buying it, borrowing it, or even pirating it.
Yeah, Jamie actually, in his lyric, it says, I gotta look it up again, but continue, I'll look it up. Internet! Google food!
I guess my taste in music start out, well, when I was a kid, I basically grew up on the Beatles and whatever was on the radio. And I actually used to turn into Disney a lot, because at the time, it wasn't about the, you know, teens on the Disney Channel getting their debut, but they actually played music.
Yeah.
You know, from, you know, old, like, 70s or 80s.
It sounds blasphemous. How could they? That's... What? I don't even...
Even if you...
he doesn't even bother finishing this. It's just...
But then, the first genre I actually really got into was techno, which was brought in, which I got into through Eiffel 65.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Eiffel 65, I didn't think it would hurt.
They can sing the blue song. I'm blue, da ba dee da ba.
Oh, them. Okay.
I have the CD, which is, the case is really worn out, but the disc play is just as fine. And that CD is pretty much my childhood and everything. You know, I remember and love about the 90s. Yeah, decade of mindless fun.
Mindless fun. My mom will attest to this, but I hated music as a kid. Absolutely, like, I wouldn't even sing the ABC song. I wouldn't do it. I just, like, no, I won't do it. And then when I got grounded, when literally the only thing I could do was read, draw, and listen to music. It was like, cool, I guess I'll listen to the city that we have lying around. So I grew up on AC/DC.
Hey.
And Ugly Kid Joe. Which, not the best thing for a kid to grow up on.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Poor kid. Being ugly as a kid and then being named Joe.
Yeah, his CD was called America's Least Wanted. And, like, AC/DC, Ugly Kid Joe, oh, and Kid Rock. Yeah. That was basically it.
I grew up off of my mother, she would play NSYNC in the car, Backstreet Boys, and at some point, Eminem, did have a phase where I was listening to Ludacris and other stuff like that, which now I look back and I think, wow, that's kind of odd and strange. Then there was Paul Simon. There was a time where I had one of his CDs and I was like, I really liked it. And there was some other vague obscure music genre I listened to, but I can't remember. Yeah. Train of thought just left the station. I'm trying to. Got my ticket. Ah, shoot. But, it's like a mixed match of what I just liked, but then I started liking just, rock and metal mostly. It started with guitar riffs and everything, and the lyrics, understanding of those go. And, yeah. Oh, I remember what it was. I used to play Grand Theft Auto Vice City and listen to Limp Bizkit.
Limp Bizkit, yep. I found the lyrics where he says, "Posture, deal it, steal it, I don't mind. Donating coins will keep us alive." Which is true. He literally says you can get the music through the torrents, buy it on iTunes, Amazon, or download it for free from SoundCloud. So, if you like it that much, you can give him money to support it. Which is how I find that if I like a song enough, like the band, I will buy their songs so that I legally have them. After you legally download them.
Probably, like, go to his house, not kind of supposed to be, "Hey, I want that song." It's like, you can go download it. I like it so much, I wanted to get it from you personally.
That'd be a little creepy.
Good, my lord. But I want that song.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Other than, you know, Beatles and, you know, Backstreet and
Sync. Beatles.
Yes. It was later on when my sister got CD Linkin Park, that's when I started exploring more into metal. So it's more of like the, you know, what a lot of, or alternative, well, Linkin Park actually falls under the category of new metal.
No, they were a bit harder, but like, they had more of a,
which, that's house. New, or that's new was spelled N-U.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, new, okay, new Gundam.
Somehow, someway, you'll always put in a Gundam reference.
Well, it's new, and it's, well, although New Gundam, it says NU, but it's spelled with a V kind of thing. I think that's the, forget what type of lettering that is. But, yes. But, they had, I liked Hybrid Theory the most because that was the first thing that I grew up with. And then as they kept going on, it was more of a technical sound. Like it was more going into a technical sound. And I was like, I miss the old ways. The guitars and the,
I can understand that, but sometimes a band just needs to evolve. Otherwise, if they don't, sometimes they die.
But I want to press B to cancel.
There's a Linkin Park. There's a vine of every parent's nightmare, and it's a dude walking by like the kid's backpack, and he looks inside, and you see a pistol, a bag of weed, like a CD case underneath, and he goes, pulls out the CD case, and it's a Linkin Park, and he goes, "Oh God." And then it starts playing a Linkin Park song.
Which was it, Crawling or?
I can't remember, but he's all like, "Oh God." Because I remember Linkin Park, I liked Linkin Park when I was in high school, and then I listened to him again. I'm like,
"Eh." It changed.
Yeah. No, like, I'll listen to the same songs. Oh. And I'm like, my outlook changed. Like, I'm not. I'm not a high school student anymore. That's the best way to put it.
Not a high school. I have no feelings for this anymore.
Yeah, adolescent phase.
Of course, Epic Rap Battles of History. I think if you're on the internet, you've heard of Epic Rap Battles of History at this point.
Yeah.
So I don't even need to talk about that. But have you heard of Epic Rap Battles of Equestria?
Yep.
See, there's like four or five different versions of Rap Battles of Equestria. What have you seen?
I've seen Prince Blue Blood versus
Big Mac.
Big Mac, and then Trixie versus Twilight.
There's actually two different versions, neither of which are those, but they actually get people that are really good, like really good imitators of the voices. And one of them is Epic Rap Battles of Equestria, and one is Epic Raps of Equestria. And one of them is Iron Will versus Zakora.
I saw that from the group.
Which is great. And the other one is Queen Chrysalis versus, sorry, he has to win, Discord.
I gotta see that one.
Oh, it's good. Because they actually use clips from the show and make it look like they're rapping against each other. And so it's actually really good. Unfortunately, like a couple months ago, the one with Discord and Chrysalis, they said, there's gonna be more stuff. And then they haven't done anything since then. And before that, it had been like a year since the last video, so
I'm still waiting. I want to see more, because it's so awesome.
Insert Hulk piano music.
No, I don't want to get copyrighted. I had like 5 seconds of the... I had like 5 seconds of the Ghostbusters music at one point in one of my videos, and then like, no copyrighted. I'm like, damn it. Like 5 seconds!
Get this mess out of here! No!
Yeesh.
Yeah.
So uptight these days.
I can understand it. I mean,
you're not making money off this. You can't do that.
See, that's the thing. If it's not my stuff, if it's directly not mine, I don't monetize it. Like for anyone who's actually listening to this podcast, will probably know I've made my channel off of Mondo Pony and Pop Wilson, which obviously I'm fans of those. I do not monetize those videos because that music is not mine.
Yeah.
That's how I feel. That's not my music. I'm just a fan who put things together. That's how it is.
To work for the music and make it sound even better.
Mm-hmm. Now, if you want to donate to me, I can't stop you. I used to have it where I would say, please donate a penny. A penny. A single penny. That's all I need.
A penny a day can change your life.
Oh.
Although it would take a life to get enough pennies to change it.
And unfortunately, y'all kept saying metal, and I love metal. I'm a big metal fan. In fact, I think you two would like E-Rock. Ever heard of this guy? He's a guitarist on YouTube who makes Blank meets metal. So Skyrim meets metal, Batman Beyond Intro meets metal, Iron Man meets metal, yeah, all these different things.
Is that the guy who's, you know, his videos, he's playing on the guitar and pretty much playing those songs?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've seen.
Yeah, he's really, have you seen his Batman Begins Intro meets metal?
Not yet.
It is amazing. I need to pull that up.
I've seen his Metal Gear meets metal.
Yes. So it's really good. I'm subscribed, and I listen to him a lot, and he's awesome. I just sometimes always like, this needs, like lyrics, please. This is awesome.
He even did My Little Pony, and that video was funny because he was looking at the camera like, you guys.
I was wanting to watch Batman Beyond, and that was fun to hear at some point. So my mind went to a different direction. Go ahead, I'm going to watch that. And then, like, go and do something. I was like, what's it going to do?
What was this thing that we were going to do again? Another one I think y'all would like was, he's a metal / screamo, Amnam. Ever heard of him? Amnam.
Hmm.
He's an interesting artist because people consistently ask him, are you on drugs? And he's like, no, this is how I am. Because he uses music as an emotional release from his life. And he also, what he does with his music is he tells a story. Like, every album is, I think he said every album is a book and every song is a chapter.
Nice.
So, yeah, and he has like 4 albums out now. And they're really nice. And in fact, he just got like a new editing software and stuff. And so he took all of his old songs down and he's gonna remaster them and put them up for free later. Yeah. And so he's awesome. And he's really just crazy. And he's awesome. But he's a lot of like it's metal. It's like and one of my favorite songs of his is I can't remember the name of it, but it's like metal, new metal, and like Jamaican, the reggae at one point. And he does like 3 different voices and all this other stuff. He's really good. And he tells a story with it. And it's like really sad. Yeah. But it's good.
All of a sudden you hear that my phone will fall into the category of avant-garde, but...
Yeah, I'm putting a link to everything you talked about in the description. I'll definitely bring up Amneon as well, so for y'all to listen to. But yeah, no, I got a lot of stuff here. I'm just trying to find metal. Dr. Sumpony. How did I forget him? Dr. Sumpony is a new musician online. YouTube. I feel like a hipster saying this. But I don't really...
got your glasses.
I don't... And my fedora, and my scarf, and my chipotle latte from Starbucks.
And your plaid shoes.
And my plaid shoes. And my overalls. Well, suspenders, anyway. Yeah, I feel like I should say this, but I don't really listen to mainstream music now. It's just mostly independent musicians from YouTube.
No one can really blame you.
Really, but Dr. Sumpony is this musician, Bonnie, of course. If his name didn't tell you enough, on YouTube, and he makes metal music, and is really good. He did like one song, and he switched to like 12 different versions of metal. Like he did classic metal, heavy metal, screamo metal, death metal, new metal, all for one song. It's like 4 minutes long. Yeah, he's got talent, and he's still new. Like he's got a couple hundred fans at the most. He's really new. So he deserves a lot of love.
Advertisement.
Yeah, no, honestly. Because it's funny. He always, because whenever you post something, I'm like, oh, this is a great song. This is really good. And he's like, thank you. You always comment. Thank you. I'm just like, cool. And when we're done with this, when we post this podcast, I will tell him, by the way, we talked about you. Yeah, for real. Trying to find any on him. Okay. Freak Kitchen. Have you ever heard this song? This band, Freak Kitchen?
Feels like
they're like Polish or Welsh or something like that. Something from over there, but they're metal. They have a song called Freak of the Week. And it's all about how they trying to be a viral video, like me with the Facebook button and all that, and they have a song called "I'm Saving Up" (parentheses for each asshole). They are metal. Yeah, that's all I got from metal.
Like I said, I started off with Linkin Park and. Later down the road, it was System of a Down. I love System of a Down.
System of a Down.
As a matter of fact, I'm wearing the shirt right now.
Oh, yes, you are.
And I also really like Serge Tankian's side project that he did after when the System of a Down, parted ways to, pursue their own musical interests. But they actually came back together.
Oh, okay. That's good.
Yeah. I wonder if they're going to make another album. But if they are, I'm looking forward to it. And, the guitarist, Darren, he actually did his own thing, Scars on Broadway, I think it was. They were pretty good. But it was in high school. A friend, one of my metal friends, Chris, he was the one who showed me a variety of metal, and another friend of mine. And he got me into Hammerfall, and it was like a mix of early 80s metal, only much really heavy, really powerful. And the newer stuff, they're kind of experimenting with their touches. But one of my all favorite songs from Hammerfall is Natural High.
I think I've heard of them before. Which, because we're talking about metal, have you ever heard of the podcast called Metal Up Your Ass?
No.
It is a podcast about all things metal. They even have a game called Metal or Not, where one of the hosts gives the other host a list of 10 things and you have to tell whether or not it's metal. Like, Frostbite, metal or not. Lions. They had like a whole, like, they have a theme every time. It's, snow. It's like, what happens during winter? No, what happens during winter? Yeah, metal, but not winter. Metal. It's not metal. And then, like, Frostbite, yeah, that's metal. A bunch of stuff like that. And they talk about basically just metal shit, which is one of the reasons I thought, why can't I make a podcast? Stuff. Sit around and talk about people. Unfortunately, they haven't, like, updated in, like, forever.
Wow.
So, they'll still I'll put a link to them in the description as well. With the page. And they also have another one called Super the Hottest. No, I have no idea what they would say Super the Hottest is supposed to mean. Yes. My computer's slow today.
And before getting the CDs, I used to listen to Hammerfall a lot on YouTube, which then I got links to other bands, and since then, I've been listening a lot more to foreign bands. And especially ones, you know, that are different languages, like a lot of German metal, Finnish. And eventually I got into Ailstorm. And
that was on my. Me and Ro. I completely forgot about that, putting it on the list. I was literally thinking, I'm going to ask them, have they ever heard of Scottish pirate metal?
Oh. Me and Ro saw them live.
I hate you both.
It was my first concert ever. Like, live, actual concert.
Where did they perform?
Atlanta. The Masquerade.
Oh, really?
Wait a minute. You guys keep going. The Masquerade in Atlanta.
Oh my god, I think Voltaire did that too.
Hey, you gotta keep an eye on that place, because a lot of cool foreign bands, they tend to show up. Like, I missed out on the concert of Camelot and Ailstorm performing.
Ooh.
And there was another band that a friend of mine, he likes power metal, one of his favorite groups apparently, was performing. I saw the poster for it sometime when we were up there, and it was sometime this year, I think, they were performing. And I told him, I was like, oh, that's really cool. I was like, yeah, I kind of wanted to get in to, like, listen to them because of him. But I didn't think I'd ever be able to go and see that concert there. But that was a really fun time.
I'm so jealous of both of you.
The ride back was kind of, like...
We were beat.
Oh, yeah, no, I mean, it's like a con. It's just like...
A con with people jumping around and pushing you.
Yeah, it's funny. There's a picture of... Metal and country, and it's like the country parking lot, and mud everywhere, cars are like at weird angles. Metal parking lot, everything's straight line, everything's perfect, everything's fine. Concert, country people, drinks, metal.
What was the name of that other band? It was, Ailstorm, it was.
The first band that that performed was Gypsy Hawk, which I actually got to talk
Gypsy
to.
What?
Gypsy Hawk.
Gypsy Hawk? I don't know this.
We actually got to talk to them after this.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's the cool thing about the Masquerade. Depending on which level, there's the second level, which is the heaven, and then there's the first level, which is hell. We went to hell.
Oh, okay, cool. Found it.
Yeah, and the cool thing about it is you can actually catch the band members at the bar and actually talk to them, get pictures, nice. They'll sign stuff. And I actually got to talk to the lead singer and bassist for Gypsy Hawk, you know, I bought a CD and he signed it. We were talking to, it was, and the cool, it was just an awesome night for me.
Oh, you have the picture!
Well, I said...
Me and the lead vocal guitarist on Gypsy Rock. So freaking metal, yeah. Oh my god, he looks metal.
Yeah.
And during wait, is that a sleeve or is that inked on? That's inked on, ain't it?
Oh, it is, yeah.
Dang, man, his entire arms looks black.
Yeah, coolest moments, you know, he actually, during one of the songs, he jumped down on the stage and he was, you know, rocking out with everybody. And I was right next to him.
Amnion has a moment like that of, like, he was at a live show, but it was like 12 people there. Because, like, almost everyone there but him was at the bands that were just waiting to perform. And they got someone that came up and asked them, like, while in the middle of the song, and asked him, because he was freaking out, to make two lines on either side of the wall. He's like, you want me to make a wall of death with 12 people? Okay.
We almost had that experience, but I actually got lucky and managed to...
Did someone have a Mr. Smiley?
Huh?
Mr. Smiley? No? Okay, no.
Well, yeah. Happened was, you know, I was pretty much getting a bit dehydrated, went to get something to drink, and I got up on the ramp, and then the next band came on,
I think Fin Troll?
No, not Fin Troll. It was, Troll Fest.
Troll Fest.
They're like Fin Troll, only a little more on the funny side. But those guys, they pretty much advocate anyone on the floor to mosh, and they did the wall of death. And when they did it, you know, he pretty much got people lined up or making like two lines. They're like, all right, now you gotta wait for the word, wait. And they're playing this like cheery, this polka metal music. And they're like, wait, wait. And then he just said, fight! And... Oh my god.
They should have been like playing like, you know, the Mortal Kombat music. Point!
Oh, they were thrashing some song, but it just. It looked like a shark blood.
Frenzy.
It looked like a shark blood frenzy down there. I'm like, I am so glad I stayed on the ramp. But I got back down on the floor when Aelstorm started performing.
Aelstorm! I love Aelstorm. It was funny too because, like, they're such a weird combination. Scottish pirate metal? Does that even work? Can you make that into a liable musical profession?
Scottish pirate metal. How do?
So...
It's crazy enough to work.
It is! Which is funny, because, like, some songs I'm like, eh, it's okay. But then, like, you get You Are a Pirate, which became a meme.
Which actually came from this old Nickelodeon show, Lazy Town.
Mm-hmm. I remember that. And then someone then took the song and put it over Lazy Town. And the other song that I really love from them is Captain Morgan Revenge.
That was the first song.
Oh my god. What a freak out. Like, that's my favorite song. That's my favorite song by them. I haven't listened to everything they have, though.
Next one you should look up is Keyhole.
Keyhole?
Yeah, they actually have they put out two more or three more albums.
It was because of Vagabond that I learned with them. We were, like, riding around sometime, and I was, like, listening.
Keyhole or Keyhole?
Keyhole. Keyhole.
Okay. Keyhole. Okay. Sorry.
But we were just, like, driving around or so, and I was, like, listening subtly to the music. In fact, that sounds really interesting. He asked about it, and started to really like it, and I actually asked him to put some music on my PSP, and spent time listening to it while I did work with my father, and I was like, this is really good. Started to get really into it.
Another cool thing about the costume.
I have a question. I know we're supposed to be music, but are we just going to make this metal? Instead?
We'll just go back to some other genre when we feel like
it. Yeah, okay.
But yeah, at the concert.
Is that a genre? What's up?
Yeah.
You got a point.
Yeah, the concert, when Gypsy Hawk was first performing, the other bands would actually, you know, sneak in and, you know, just do crazy stuff. Like, there was a guy who came in with these rolled up paper, blunt, giant paper blunt looking things and this bowl of what I really hope was baby powder. It probably most likely was, but, you know, they were just messing around. And then they started blowing the powder into the crowd, and some of it got into my shoulder, and that's when I thought, I really hope this is baby powder.
I really hope this is baby powder. It's funny too, because, like, people, I got a lot of metal people I know, like, you guys, they have short hair. I have the hair to rock the mouth. I have the kind of hair that when I headbang, the ends of my hair are staying there and I headbang.
I used to have long hair in high school, but it became too much of a fuss, and I had more things that I wanted to focus on, and, you know, I just wanted short hair, plus it's quicker to wash.
And work dictates that my hair stays short, or else that's just not good.
Yeah, you work in food.
Yeah.
Question. I know you have that thing about work that you can't talk about it, but are you able to say where you work?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm going to say yes, but at this point, it's like, I'm not going to purposely say something I know I can't do. But,
yeah. Like, I was wondering to the extent of that thing. And I can understand of, like, I think we've said where you worked before on the podcast, right?
Yeah.
Well, do you mind if I said?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, you can.
Okay. You work at Taco Bell, but I can understand Taco Bell being like, you can't say anything about Taco Bell on social media.
Yeah.
Because of, like, we have this new big thing that's coming out. You can't tell anyone ever until it's out.
I actually had to go through a learning training program on the computer. But the whole thing is like, working here, you would not say anything on any social media about our new items. But you can tell people about how you enjoy the food here. But don't say anything like, I have a few profile pictures on Facebook, which I had taken pictures of myself in the bathroom, and after I did that, I was like, I'm surprised I didn't have any trouble for that then. In the bathroom. Also, for the fact that I didn't have to, but I was afraid also, because I had changed a few times my profile picture to someone made this joke of Sweetie Belle with the hat and the Taco Bell symbol, but it's just Sweetie Belle, and it's like, it's funny. I'm gonna use it. Cause I work there in Sweetieville, and I was like, after I thought about that, I was like, oh, I'm gonna get in trouble for that too.
I'm going to find a picture. There it is. There's a lot of them actually. There's one where she's working at Taco Bell.
Seriously.
When the wrestler walks in and goes, "Give me your churros." All of them.
That explains why we don't sell them anymore.
Did you really not? I used to love the churros.
You know what would be funnier? If it was Flea from Mucha Lucha.
Yes! Oh, I love that show. That show, I'm like, that was an awesome show.
Flea thinks we should run away and escape.
His finisher, I'm like, that's cool. If I had a finisher, I'd be like, Dragon! Yeah, they have one where she is the Taco Bell symbol with a sombrero eating a taco.
I think that was the one that I had. That's the one I had.
Yep.
Except it said Sweetie instead of Taco.
Ah. Well, Taco Bell, Taco.
I love how that became a thing.
Yeah, this is funny.
Destiny.
It became a thing. That's funny. It's a picture of grown up Sweetie Belle, and I'm like, oh, what's okay? Like, wait. Oh, it's two bells. Little on the nose.
Oh, that was another Gundam reference.
You and your Gundam references.
Londo Bell, come on. It's totally, I need to get that.
The deal has changed. Do not make me change it again. Anyway, what were we talking about?
Metal.
Or
music in general, but we were still stuck on the genre of metal.
Metal! Yeah. Because
metal's awesome.
Metal! I can't think of... Yeah, I'm so jealous of you guys. Are you all planning on going back there anytime soon?
Not unless there's, you know, anyone we really want to see.
Well, if you ever do, tell me, because I want to come with. Like, hardcore. Have you ever heard of a group called Napalm Records?
Yeah, that's where a lot of the bands I listen to come
from. Yeah. That's where, Ailstorm, that's who produces their music, so I'm like, oh, Ailstorm's really cool. And then I heard, like, Lee's eyes, and I'm like, oh, that's really good, mm-hmm. and a bunch of other stuff, and I'm like, okay, yeah, I subscribe to them and listen to their stuff every once in a while that comes out. So, kind of fallen away from that, unfortunately. Yeah. So.
Well, on the plus side, you got so much to look forward to.
Yes, yes, yes.
There's a lot of cool bands. There's this one band, I think the Russian, it's called, I'm probably butchering this name, Grushkaja or something. Yeah. That one of their songs was Energia.
Do you have any idea how to spell that?
My
name? I don't want to move too much unless the mic be.
I'll just.
Ruskata, yeah. I was kind of saying their name is Ruskata.
Ruskata. Oh, wow, the picture. The picture is a bunch of Russian people doing the, you know, the stereotypical Russian dance. Oh, it's in Napalm Records. I might have heard of these people then.
But the next song I also really liked was A Change, where, you know, the singer, he's talking in English, but, you know, it's pretty much the video is him going around the place, and there's these devils sabotaging his hotel room.
Oh.
Like, you know, putting the plastic wrap.
I just hate that, man. The devil sabotaging a hotel room. Just want to sleep. Don't hate that.
Plastic wrap on the toilet seat.
Oh, that's just mean.
Electrifying the doorknob.
That.
You should do a
I want to see this as a cartoon now.
Remind me to get on the topic of folk metal.
Folk metal.
Anyway. So, yeah, he's talking about how he had to
change. Don't forget to go on folk metal.
There you go.
That's your mind.
Yeah, the song was a lot about, you know, he was changing things based on American influences, but it was having a lot of negative impacts on him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like,
I changed some for McDonald's, and now I've got all this.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, McDonald's. You just had to say McDonald's, and be like, yep, okay, I understand. It's weird, too, if, like, you don't eat McDonald's for, like, a couple months, and you go to eat McDonald's, and you're like, you're not used to it anymore. It's weird.
I've never eaten at McDonald's for, like, about a year or so.
Yeah, you don't eat at McDonald's. Oh, okay.
On to folk metal.
Folk metal?
One of my favorite folk metal bands is Korpikalani. In their language, which is it's a Finnish language, it means a forest clan.
Hmm.
Yeah, I collect a lot of their CDs, and one of my favorite song from them of all time is Keep on Galloping.
Keep on Galloping. And
their music video is hilarious. If you watch the music video, it's basically this, you know, this guy, you know, cutting down trees, and the band is just, you know, glaring at him, and then they start doing, like, all these hexes on him. When the song, all it's about is a guy riding around on a horse.
I looked it up.
Thing is, you would never know that because they sing it in their language, and that's pretty much the song. He's talking about how he rides around on his horse through all these lands. Yeah, the music video is about this, you know, message of nature.
What, you mean the meshes of nature that's not heavy-handed?
How can we make this video confusing? Let's make it about nature while singing about a guy
riding on a horse.
But they've actually been jokingly called beer metal because a lot of the songs, it's nature, but also, you know, but drinking and, you know, just...
Oh, have you ever heard the beer song?
Yeah.
Have you ever heard the beard song?
No.
Like, it's by the same people, but it's all about beards. Like,
Psycho Sticks?
Yes, it's by Psycho Sticks, but it's all about beards and how beards are awesome and they will help you in everything you do. Like, stuck out in the middle of the woods and your phone has no charger, you need a charger? Go beard! Feed the beard, manscape the beard! A bunch of different. It's fun, it's crazy.
Yeah.
I gotta look that up now and put that on the list as well of things to splice into the podcast.
Now you got me thinking of the beer song. Yeah. In music appreciation, I did a paper on metal and all the subgenres.
Wow. How'd that go over?
Oh, it was great, and I even discovered genres I never knew about.
Oh, that's good.
Like avant-garde metal.
Ooh.
And... There's a song I found. I forgot his name, but it's called Chaos Road or something. If I were to show that song to you, you pretty much call that Discord's theme song. It's just so symphonically chaotic.
What's it called?
Got it on my MP3. I could probably just find the name there, but.
So you're saying it's quite a
trip. It's a trip.
I have a whole, like. I have like 10 YouTube things up. Anyway, as you look that up, is there anything else of metal before we move into another genre of music?
I also discovered I already knew about black metal, but I started doing research, and originally, you know, it was started by the band Venom. They just put satanic lyrics for the sake of shock value. But meanwhile, over in, I think, Norway, this band called Golgoroth, they took it to some extremes.
Golgoroth.
And it wasn't just, you know, putting animal blood and severed heads of animals on their stage. They've actually advocated and participated in church burnings, and...
Wow.
A friend of mine also told me about this other group of black metal...
Don't burn churches, kids. Don't do that at home.
Yeah, don't burn churches. Anyway, there was this other group who...
They make terrible shit.
Yeah. One of their music...
I'm sorry. That was good.
One of the band members blew their head off, and the other bandmates, they took a picture of that and put it as an album cover.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Wait. Oh my
goodness. Well... Black metal still continues to be influenced in this day and age, especially for like Dimmu Borgir and a lot of other bands. Another group I really react. Going off topic of black metal, another group I have listened to is Ex-Dio, which they do a lot of Romanesque themed stuff.
I think I've heard of them.
Yeah, Caligula.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
While you look that up,
I'm going to play Pong.
Do y'all listen to, like, you said dubstep and stuff, do you?
Mostly the stuff that I've heard from, when I got into MLP, that's when I started actually listening to.
Yeah, they made some surprisingly good dubstep stuff.
I want to say back when I was, like, listening, it was like 90% of the stuff that I heard was dubstep and small bits of other stuff. Like, I was wanting so much to find someone who did metal or so, which, thank God, I found Bonafide. That was one of the reasons. He even did Carol of the Bells in metal, which I save and listen to every year. That's going to make Christmas better than making it metal.
Metal.
Oh, by the way, as a joke, one year I was listening to so many, like, I was at work and I heard all the freaking Christmas songs playing over the speaker because I didn't do that, and at some point I started making really horrible versions of them and thinking, oh, hey, I can make myself a death metal Christmas album with all this.
I would listen to it.
Little reindeer, and mommy saw, you know, I saw mommy killing Santa Claus and stuff like that. And the little joke for Randolph the little reindeer was he led Satan's army on Christmas Eve. I was so annoyed at Christmas songs so much at that point.
Well, I can understand.
Yeah, you should look at Bob Rivers then.
Nuclear Holocaust. Christmas nuclear winter moon.
Or listen to the Night Santa when Crazy but Weird Al.
Yes! He's on my list of things too. I was just trying to find a way to insert him in there. He's actually, his last album that came out, Mandatory Fun, is his last album. Because his contract went out. So instead, what he's going to do is whenever he hears a song that he thinks he wants to, go ahead and write the song, shoot the video, and post it on his website. I'll post it on his YouTube. So he's still going to be making stuff, he just won't be in albums. Which I'm subscribed to his YouTube channel, so.
Did you know that the night Santa Went Crazy has two endings?
Really?
There's a more violent ending of that song.
Really? I've only heard the one where he went to jail.
The other one, he gets shot.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, just look it up. The Night Santa Went Crazy, Gory Edition.
Gory Edition. Well, thank you for that transition, because I want to talk about Creature Feature.
Yeah!
Do you know Creature Feature? Creature Feature is this... What would you call them? What kind of music do they make? It's hard to... They make, like, it's really dark, weird stuff.
Macabre. Macabre rock.
Macabre rock. But they have a song called A Gory Demise, where they actually open the song with they're all monsters, and they're talking about how I brought you here today to recite the annual obituaries that we do every year. We'll start with A and then with Z. Band, are you ready?
Ready.
Begin, and they start playing, and it's like A is for Amber, who drowned in a pool. B is for Billy, who's eaten by ghouls. C is for Comet, with disease of the brain. D is for Daniel, who got derailed on the train, and things like that. And they just keep going. They do the whole alphabet, and it gets weird. And they have a lot of other songs.
One of my favorite songs from them, other than The Greatest Show on Earth.
Yeah.
The song I really like from them is Such Horrible Things.
I think I've heard that one. That one's up.
I'm not a bad man, even though I do bad
things. Yeah, I've heard that one.
That's one of my favorites.
Here There Be Witches was a good one. But I really liked. Unfortunately, that is about the only transition I had for that. So do y'all listen to rap? Or R&B?
Rap varies a lot for me. Like, I listen to some groups. Like, there's this one, Flowbots. I really like their song Handlebars.
I like Handlebars, yeah. I actually like the lyric of that he's a rapper. I like that. I just like Handlebars in beginning with.
Of course, the first was sort of Linkin Park, which metal with the rap.
Yeah. Trying to find everyone. Let's see. Dan Bull. He's a good rap. He's a good rap artist. That he makes a lot of music. Definition. Nope. He did the same. He did a song about Binding of Isaac. Ego Raptor, Ninja Sex Party.
Oh, yeah, I've been listening to Starbomb. Yeah, I actually listened to both the Kim and the U this morning. And
I love that laid out summertime jam. I love that song.
I've actually been playing it like 3 or 4 times.
Hey, Liz.
Well, thank you, old man.
Oh, yeah. I thought that's what you were referencing when you sang that. Epic Lloyd. He's one half of the Epic Rap Battles Mystery. The other half is Nice Beetle. Greedy Graffiti. Have you heard of the song with this band? Rap artist. He's online. He only has like 3 songs, and one is called Muffin Tops, where he sings about girls with muffin tops. The other one is Cocklocked, which is all about being cocklocked. And the third one was about Facebook, and he hates that likes and pokes and all this and sharing and mindless stuff is virus and he hates it. Hi, I'm Ron. He doesn't anymore. He used to do a series of game of songs called Gets Played. So like Minecraft gets played, Pokemon gets played, and he laughs about the game. Jack Lab. He's a bony rap musician. Oh, I shouldn't say rap, but he's a bony musician. He's really good.
I know there was one person I listened to. It was like a lesson I learned or so. I don't know if that was the same person. But One Trick Pony.
One Trick Pony, that's it. That's, yeah, Jack Lapp's part of that. JT Machinima. No? He's another rap musician who's all about games. But he, like, pumps out music like crazy, like, one week. Mac Lethal. He did the kind of, like, England Viral, the ABC song, the ABC rap, where he, like, the first handful of lyrics is all starting with A's, and then all with B's, and then all with C's, and he does it super fast. He has, like, he's holding the record for the fastest song, fastest rap in history, I think.
I heard about that when Daniel Radcliffe was on the Jimmy Fallon show, and he actually was able to sing that.
Yeah.
And rap that.
Next Gen or Runner. Ever heard of him? He hasn't been putting out music for the past year, but he did a song called I'm Not Addicted, which was a song about Fallout Equestria. Have you read Fallout Equestria?
No.
Okay. But in the main character in the book, it's not really a book, but the main character gets addicted to a drug. And so the song is called I'm Not Addicted, about how, like, in denial, eventually in the end, she decides to get off the drugs. Another one is called Murder, Murder, and it has a bunch of references to My Little Pony anime. Like, it's crazy. Like, I had to look up half of the references he made. He also is crazy. And then he recently, like last week, made a new YouTube profile called Renna, and he's making new music in that. Open-minded music. It's a band, three people. They have a song called Razor Rifle. It is a song based off of the weapon Razor Rifle from Fallout 3. And it's really good. It's so good, I went out and bought it for $1. And then they haven't really put anything out that I know of, but Lab Rats. They're a rap group from Michigan, I wanna say. I'm probably totally wrong on that, so don't quote me. But they're a rap group that's really like they don't have a single chorus in their entire one song. So it's nothing but them rapping for straight 5 minutes. So I'm just like, that's talent. I hate songs where it's like 5 or 6 lines and then a chorus that's 30 seconds long and then 5 or 6 lines and then a chorus that's like, oh. So, what are you looking at?
I finally found the avant-garde artist I was telling you about. His name is Arcturus and the song is called The Chaos Path.
The Chaos Path? Okay. I gotta look that up too.
Yeah.
That doesn't scream Discord, I don't know.
No, Discord. Point.
That's practically, if it's not his theme song, it's definitely on his MP3.
He listens to it while he sits in his thick machine.
Or when he's in his pocket dimension of chaos.
I want to see his pocket dimension of chaos. It's literally a pocket. And recently, I've gotten into like 20s, 30s music, kind of, and in that, I have to go with the Wasteland Wailers. They're a Fallout Equestria based song, because Fallout is based in like the 40s, 30s and 40s, and the Wasteland Wailers are the pony-fied version of that, of Fallout Equestria. And it's, the band is what is played during the Fallout Equestria game. Because that's what they're making, and they hired the Wasteland Wailers to make, the people that made Wasteland Wailers to make these songs. And they're really good. They're like, if you like 20s, 30s, and 40s music, you'll love them. But Al, we already talked about that. Oh, Andrew Hong. He does a lot of stuff with Boy in a Band. And one of the things he recently made was a song where he mixed trap music and funk music. It is good. Like, oh, it's really good. And he'll have a bloney dance party. He does a lot of, like, music and PMVs.
I try to listen to some of this stuff, but I normally like to get a hear of it, and then if I can download it, I download it and I listen to it. And repeatedly. Because then I can just...
repeat it till it gets bad.
When I want to listen to music, it's when I'm either doing chores or something that I want background music for. Mm. And I don't ever really, like, actually go to look for something. If I see something and say, oh, that looks interesting, while I'm doing something else, I'll look at it and save it for later. So if I can't save it for later, I tend to not, you know, put huge investment into it.
And it's not exactly music related, but I love musicals, specific kind of musicals. Yeah, honestly, actually, Burlesque. Actually, that song Burlesque is in my rotation of music. But two of them that we talked about was Repo and Devil's Cornhole. I love. By the way, there's a sequel of Devil's Cornhole coming out.
Get to see the name of that.
It's a they have a trailer called The Librarian out now. It's really good. And I also want to do a special thanks to Inkpots, which is the animatics group that showed the Hell to Your Doorstep one I showed you just recently.
Yeah.
That they did that, and they do a bunch of musicals, which really got me back into the musical genre. So I want to thank them because they're really awesome. Go check them out. Steam Pal Giraffe. Have you heard of them? They're a basically whatever kind of also suits their fancy, but a bit of techno, kind of robotics feel. They are literally like their characters in the band are robots. One was built during like the 1800s. Another one was built for the Worldwide Science Expo in the 60s. And another one they really don't know, but they're robots and they play music. So it's actually really cool. Voltaire.
Oh yeah, I know him.
Voltaire's great. I think that's all we have to really say.
That and Billy and Mandy.
Billy and Mandy! If you grew up on Billy and Mandy, if you're a 90s kid, you grew up on Billy and Mandy. If you do that, he's the one that did all the songs.
Yeah, with that you're a 90s kid, some people find that very offensive.
I don't care.
Facebook. Facebook ruins everything.
Anyone who says that on Facebook.
I don't understand how that could be offensive.
Because they would make, if you're like this if you're the 90s kid, like this if you remember this, like this.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I still don't see how that's offensive. Though there is a good, there's a thing of how, you know, verifying your age and you put your age in. Instead it said, you must verify your age. What is this? And it showed a picture of VHS.
I wouldn't know. I was in around that time that you showed me a record. I could tell you just fine.
Wow.
Well, yeah, 90s kid and proud.
Same.
I was born on the 90s, so you can't.
You had the full 90s spectrum. Fortunately, I can't say the same, exactly. But I'm still a 90s kid.
Well, on the topic of that, yesterday, while building this, was watching a reviewer who mostly does 20s, but he does old cartoon reviews, brought back to light some cartoons that were from the 90s that I either forgot about or never knew of. One really kind of cruddy one was called Toxic Crusaders.
Toxic Crusaders!
And I know that. One other one was something called Cyber Six, which apparently was based off it was either a manga or a comic from either Japan or Germany, I can't remember which one. And the source material was a lot more mature than what we had in America.
America seems to do that a lot.
You know, we should actually do an episode on cartoons.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Also, I have to ask this. Have any of you guys heard of an old cartoon called Centurions?
I think so, yeah.
I think I have.
The ones with the pieces.
Power Extreme!
Then, yes, I remember watching that. That's one of the first things I liked that was somewhat robotic.
I think I have. I have to look them up.
One guy had, like,
one was an airplane, one was a submarine, and one was pretty much a tank.
Yeah. I don't think I have.
I'll go into more detail on that when we actually talk about
cartoons.
On the topic of old style music, my sister had the Great Gatsby soundtrack, and I heard this song called "Love Is the Drug" by Roxy Music. Yeah, I really like that style. You know, smooth, but with those instruments, like brass and the string,
jazz, blues.
It's sort of
big band music.
Yeah, I really like that smooth style of music.
You would definitely like the newest song just released by the Wasteland Wailers then. It's really good, and it is ponies, so.
Yeah.
Automatic bonus points. It's really good, so.
Also, soundtrack to both Blues Brothers movies.
Yes! That is actually, yes. Do you have any other things about music?
For dubstep, I've only listened to dubstep from Brony Music and a few from, like, I really like the song from Far Cry 4.
I haven't played the game, so I don't
know. Not Far Cry 4, Far Cry 3, you know? When you're burning the field and it plays that one song. Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, but... it's sort of a mixed bag with me for some. I like some Shrillex and soft. I like some songs, but then, you know, I kind of had no choice but to listen to dubstep when I was enjoying it too, because, you know, whoever had the iPhone in the playlist, that's what we listened to, and nonstop dubstep, and somebody had some very boring rap.
At that point, a good thing to have is just like a phone connected to the internet and bring up Hive Radio. Because that's what I do, basically, is when I have nothing less to listen to, I have radio.
I would have used my earphones thing is they didn't allow it because there was a 3D art class nearby with a lot of dangerous equipment, and they made it a rule not to wear music earbuds.
Oh, yeah, understandable.
Yeah.
You want to do news real quick? So Windows is going to be upgrading. Well, do we have anything else about music?
No.
I'm honestly grasping at straws here.
Windows
is upgrading Windows 8 to Windows 10 for everybody. Even if you have an illegal version of Windows 8.
So this could be 9.
They escaped. They've done that. but it's basically because, like, in India and Asia, the 90% of Windows are not genuine versions. And it's not because of their issues, it's the people that sell computers put illegal versions on there, and then the people that have them get pissed with Windows. So Windows is like, Windows 10 for everybody. You get a Windows 10! You get a Windows 10! Everyone gets Windows 10!
Yay!
I wanted Windows 9.
They went like Windows 8, Windows 8.1, and then Windows 10. I don't know what happened to 9.
it's just like
Monty Python syndrome.
Yeah, basically.
I've been doing that.
They've done that a lot. Actually, they've skipped numbers. Another bit of information. You know, Mortal Kombat 10 is coming out, right? Mortal Kombat X. Mortal Kombat. Guess who's gonna be on the list?
Jason
and Predator.
Oh, Predator! Oh, nice.
Yeah, Predator's on the list.
There was speculation about it, and I heard from this one guy I was watching for a while that they were saying that Predator was gonna be about it, but then he said, "Well, they probably can't do that because it's owned by a movie."
They got the license to use him. The cool thing is, there was speculation of, because they're bringing in movie tie-ins, and that he now has a new movie coming out, Mad Max could show up. Because Mad Max is owned by one of the companies they've already dealt with. So they could bring in Mad Max, because he has a new movie coming out.
Also, there was some speculation that Spawn might make an appearance someday.
Yeah, that too.
I would really love to see Isaac Clarke. That would be interesting.
Ooh. He's already been in one, though. Isaac Clarke?
What game?
PlayStation All Stars, I think.
Oh yes. I mean, but
like, yeah, damn it! Why couldn't it have been a good game?
I only came up with some fatalities. Like,
he stomps him to death.
Yeah, like.
You know what would be funny though? If one of his fatalities was he just stands there, and like a vent pops up on the edge of the map, and just like, what are you doing? And then the vent explodes open, and one of the. What are they called?
Necromorphs
comes out, grabs it, and yanks him in, and that's it. Or puts him in the giant eye machine and stabs him through the eye.
Like, that was one of my things, was like, he would just like. Basically, somehow summon a necromorph and it would just come out and just kill him in the most brutal way. Like, I even thought of like the one that like grabs you around the neck and
wears off and yeah.
puts itself there. You're like, and it's just like,
so.
Fatality.
Fatality.
And then he shoots it and then kills it as well.
Unfortunately for Metal Gear fans, the creative Metal Gear Solid, I'm gonna not even try to pronounce his name because I'm gonna butcher it.
Kojima.
He's leaving Konami.
Yeah.
In general. Just.
Yeah, everyone told me about that.
I saw it one day when I got off work and I was sitting at home, and I saw his ears like, what's this? I have to tell him.
But this doesn't necessarily mean, or does he say that he's retiring or he's just leaving?
I think he's retiring, I'm not sure though.
It was, from what I read, it was something about they had, him and Konami had some issues.
Yeah. I don't know, I don't think, it wasn't said in the description that I heard. Unfortunately, I think we did bring this up in a podcast. Oh no, it wasn't during the podcast. But remember the evacuation website thing? About, like, that was supposed to be connected to Half-Life 3.
Mm-hmm.
Gabe Newell himself said, there is no Half-Life 3. It's not going to happen. Because it is basically it's a dead series, and unless there's a ton of people in Valve itself that want to do it, he's not going to have it done.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and he said even then we probably still wouldn't have it done. So, either he's telling the truth and we're never going to get a Half-Life 3, or he's pulling the biggest wool sweater over our eyes.
Next month is April.
Also, he might be hanging out with a guy who did the Five Nights at Freddy's thing. When's it coming out? Oh, I can't tell you. Bam! Next week.
I love that. He's just like, by the way, I am making a third one. Oh, cool. When's it coming out? I don't know. Next week. Boom! Done! Boom! Done!
Also, I finally saw those videos. Or I finally saw the videos of Markiplier playing it.
Yeah, oh my god.
So, right now, I'm still waiting for Game Theorist to do something, but...
With number three? Game Theorist actually showed up in the Completionist to talk about three.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. There's a Attack on Titan live movie coming out.
Oh.
And the trailer is out.
Nice.
I haven't seen it.
Some of the actors I know of, I don't know who they are. I don't know which actress it is, but two of them are from one character. One person is from the show Kamen Rider O's, and the other is from another series called Go Busters.
I think... Okay, the Pixels movie trailer came out. Have you seen that?
I saw a giant Pac-Man.
Yeah, there's a giant... Basically, what there was... I think this actually happened, too, where we sent a time capsule into space with a bunch of stuff about our culture, and one of them included, like, Atari games, like Pac-Man, Space Invaders, things like that, and... Aliens took it the wrong way. And now, this is where the movie takes off. Aliens took it the wrong way. And they come in and they have giant pixelated versions of the video games, and they start killing things. Like, whenever they, like, Pac-Man, he starts eating everything, but when he eats it, the moment he touches it, it turns pixelated, and he eats it. And they actually get in, I'm not joking about this, they actually get in the actual dude who made Pac-Man to act in the movie. So it's actually, it was not bad, but it has, Happy Gilmore. Adam Sandler. Adam Sandler, which a lot of his movies lately is really hit and miss with me. Like, sometimes they're okay, other times, like, I didn't think that was funny at all. So, I don't know. I don't know how that'll be. The Titanfall 2 is basically kind of confirmed. Not fully, but kind of.
I saw the Chappie movie.
Oh, good. What'd you think about it?
I liked it a lot, and to describe it, it's basically RoboCop with the mind of Pinocchio.
I always was describing it as the dude wanted to make RoboCop, and he was a giant fan of Short Circuit 2.
There actually is quite a few resemblances of RoboCop in there. But
yeah, because he wanted to make the RoboCop movie, but he couldn't get the license to it. So,
but yeah, it's a good movie, and actually, for the topic of music, there are actually musicians in there.
Yeah, they're not that good. From what I heard, they're not that good of actors. And I've listened to some of their music, and it's kind of weird.
Yeah, their music is weird.
And that's saying something, considering what we listen to. Frozen 2 is confirmed.
Or as we like to call it, Super Mega Hype Part 2.
Did you hear about... Did y'all watch Breaking Bad?
Yes.
Did you watch Breaking Bad?
I haven't been to watch it.
Well, you know the scene where he throws a pizza up on the roof, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know this? The main character, Walter White, gets so angry at something that he grabs a pizza and throws it up on the roof.
Oh, I remember.
The thing is, that house wasn't... Like, it was actually... It's a real-life house owned by a nice old lady. Fans of Breaking Bad are coming around to our house, but they found out what it was and are throwing pizzas under the roof. Yeah.
That poor old lady, why would you do this?
And she's really nice about it, too. So,
I love the pepperoni and my shingles.
Funny, but it's kind of rude at the same time.
There's a thing that I really want to talk about, but I'm trying to find other pieces of information. I can't see any other bits of news that we talk about. Basically, Minecraft is one YouTuber. Because Minecraft, they actually have an algorithm on YouTube that explains, of all the games that are played on YouTube, which one's the most, how many of it, what's the percentile, how many are paid by the person who created the game. Number one is Minecraft. Total views, 4,310 million views. 99.9% of them are fan videos. 0.1% of them are paid for. And 40% of them share the top 20 viewed videos of all time. Number two on the list is Grand Theft Auto at 1,084 million. 3,000 million away from Minecraft. Minecraft has one YouTube.
Spell it MineTube.
MineTube. I would watch that. Well, we basically watched that anyway.
You gotta be careful when you're watching, because you might have a creeper behind you.
The wall behind me is green.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's still in your eyes and spots. But there's a distinct lack of disc.
It's camouflaged.
Oh, God. Okay. So, as we were talking, like, 20 more comments popped up on a video. So, I had to look at them all real quick. I'm sorry. Post back. So, that's basically... there's not really much else to say. Yeah, there's really not much left, except for the fact that PlayStation and Xbox are teaming up. I love the look. It was like, what?
And so that's how the apocalypse starts. Great.
Insert Bill Murray quote from Ghostbusters.
Which one?
Dogs and cats getting together.
Yeah. That's a big Twinkie.
They're
not teaming up as in, like, consoles. They're teaming up because DDoS attacks are basically always happening to them, and it's only every once in a while that one gets through and kind of messes with the online system.
It's funny lately because of, this goes back to Christmas, there was the whole, somebody attacked Sony with the whole DDoS thing, but apparently they hit Microsoft as well. Funny thing was though, Microsoft recovered way faster than
Sony. Yeah, well, that's what they're saying is they're happening every second of every day, that most of the systems can usually keep them out. It's every once in a while when the hackers learn something new or figure something else out. They're teaming up with each other to counteract this, to increase the firewalls and everything like that. Unfortunately, to a person like me who thought, why can't I make a system that has everything? They're not making a system together. Though I think they would make a ton of money if they did.
That would basically be the end-all thing that I assume that would be the future of gaming. It's like, oh, you know what, we can make some of this work together and make one big system.
Even if it only works for... Because I always thought, what if I was make a console? I'd make a pyramid. And, like, slot Xbox games, slot PlayStation 2 games, PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, and at the very top, a tiny slot for GameCube.
So called the Playbox.
The Playbox. And you can do it. People have done it online. It's possible.
I guess there's the fear of a monopoly on gaming, I guess.
PC.
Obviously. Good point.
And there's always Nintendo. Nintendo will prevail. Nintendo will survive all.
Yeah, they hold pretty well on their own.
Yeah, surprisingly, even when they're doing bad, they're still good.
Yeah, and especially when they just had the Wii and the other consoles have gone with higher graphics, they still had good games.
Yeah, I sometimes it gets in the way of like the processing, the methods, but the one thing that they say that I always stick to is that they want games to be fun.
And for everyone to play with.
Yeah.
That reminds me of a picture I saw on Facebook the other day. How Sakurai sees Smash Brothers online. We're on glory, how we see it. Weenie Hut Jr.
There's the of course the gif when the Wii first came out. It prints money.
Mario, but what do we do with all this money?
Wow, Mario.
You won't let me take it.
Which is, it's really weird. I want to say this is really, I'm sorry, I'm going backwards, but it's really weird to hear about the Half-Life 3 thing, because there was a question of, like, maybe it's going to be a VR game, which would be awesome, with Oculus Rift, but, yeah.
They should make a Johnny Mnemonic game. Yeah, like, you know, when he's, like, in the computer, like, you see him with the headset and the gloves. You should actually do that.
It's basically all the news that we have. So, guess, what did you say next week was? Anime?
Yeah.
What was the other one we were talking about? Oh, cartoons. We need to add that to the list. But... what do we want these? Do you have anything else to talk about? No? Nope? Nothing? Want to do a sign-off?
Yeah.
Okay. Rock on. I'm totally cool with that. What are you going to say? You know what? Don't even tell me.
Yeah, I can't tell you, because if I tell you, then that ruins everything.
I don't know.
Or it could be, you know, Bill and Ted's party on and be excellent to each other.
Let's do that. Party on and be excellent to each other. Okay, so ready? 3, 2, 1.
Party on and be excellent to each other.
What'd you say?
I don't even
hear you. I didn't even hear you.
Next time, I'll just use the funny soundboard and make it much better.
It's a rock. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share. Oh, and also, if you want to contact us and have your email read on the show, go to google.com, Google email, and send us an email at wottav@gmail.com.
We'd love to hear from you.
All lowercase. Yes, please do. Out of 300 views, no one has sent us an email yet. Please. We will talk about it on the show and basically answer your questions. So.
And say thank you.
Yes, baby. Repeatedly. Yeah, honestly. So, yeah. Party on. Bye.
Peace.
Adios, muchachos.